Okay, let's look at the annual results of this industry. Let's first look at the P&L. Which company has the maximum revenue in this business? It's Robotronics with 471 lakhs. And who's got the least revenue? It's AI with about 17 million. So going down the last line, which company has got the maximum profit or least losses? That's Robotronics with minus 48 lakhs of loss. And the maximum loss is with TechBots, which is about 122 lakhs or 1.2 crores. And you see that the maximum loss is not made by the company with minimum revenue. And you see that profits or losses and revenues have no real correlation with each other. It's not that higher the revenue, higher the profit, or the other way around. Also, you see that there is one company which has paid some tax here, which is Robotronics. What does this mean? This means that there is only one company in this business who's ever made a quarterly profit, and that's Robotronics. Because in this business, you pay a tax if you make a quarterly profit. And coming to your gross margin, can all of you tell me for your specific company, what is your gross margin? And let's just note it down. AI, TechBots, Robotronics, RoboKings, and RoboS. So the company who's got the highest gross margin, which is gross margin divided by revenue as a percentage, is Robotronics, which is close to about 33%. While you have the least gross margin with is with TechBots, who have something about 20 odd percent. So if you really look at it, you also see that there is a good correlation between the gross margin and the profits that companies are making. So the more margins that you have, the more profits companies are also able to make here. So coming down to inventory holding cost, which company did not have excess inventory a lot of times? Which company was able to manage their inventory quite well? TechBots followed by Robotronics. And you see that AI and RoboKings have had trouble with a lot of inventory. So let's do something. Let's compare the inventory holding cost, this line, with this line, the short-term interest. So do you see any correlation between this line and this line? Yes, you see that those companies which have low inventory holding costs are also companies which have low short-term interest, which also includes emergency loans. And companies who have high inventory holding costs also have paid high interest, which means companies which have low inventory holdings also had more certainty in cash inflows, thus they didn't have to take emergency loans. Companies with huge inventory did not have cash, they had to go take emergency loan. And companies like AI have already paid 15 lakhs of short-term interest. This is not the loan, this is just the interest. Coming to some of these expenses, you see that a lot of companies have made a lot of expense. For instance, TechBots has spent a lot of money on sales and after sales and advertising, closely followed by Robotronics. And you also see that AI has spent quite a bit of money on after sales, but that's nothing when compared to what the other people in the industry are spending. So now moving to the balance sheet, the first thing that we notice is that all the companies in the industry have run out of cash. Which means all of us have gone into emergency loans. And you also see that TechBots as a company has run into a stockout situation where they've not been able to cater to their demand in the market. And you have companies like Robotronics, RoboKings, and S-Robo having a lot of inventory. So moving down, looking at the plant, you see that TechBots still have only one plant, but Robotronics have three plants, and the other companies, RoboKings, RoboS, and AI, have two plants each. But a question, TechBots has one plant, Robotronics has three plants, but then you see that the depreciation is the same. How is that? Yes, the depreciation is the same because TechBots and Robotronics till the end of quarter four had the same amount of plants, which means both of them had only one plant. I would presume that Robotronics had added their two plants in the fourth quarter, which is going to start being operational in the fifth. Is that right, Robotronics? Yes. So, is that a good decision? We'll come to that in a short while. The next is the research investment. You see that Robotronics and RoboKings have invested a lot of money in research, while AI has not invested in research at all. So does this give us an indication of where different companies are trying to sell? Possibly AI has not invested anything. So who do you think they're trying to sell to? Possibly wholesalers and maybe OEMs, okay. But then you see Robotronics has invested a lot of money. Who do you think Robotronics is trying to sell to? Maybe VAR. And again, RoboKings have also invested money. So who do you think they are trying to sell to? OEMs, okay, or VAR. Maybe VAR. So let's just take this number 0, 1.6 lakhs, 8 lakhs, 4 lakhs and 1.6 lakhs and compare it with the innovation report. And if you look at the innovation report, you see that AI, as we expected, are still selling integration level or version 1, while Robotronics and RoboKings are already starting to sell version 3. You also see that Robotronics are investing in other research projects like defect rate reduction and automation as well. So this gives us some indication of where different players in the industry are moving and who they are really trying to sell to. If you look at the kind of, if you go down on the balance sheet and if we look at common stock, this is the money that Singhania had invested in the business. But there is a small concern here when we look at the long-term loans. What is the maximum long-term loan that you can avail in a quarter, in the lifetime of your company? That's 1.2 crores. And you see that one company has already hit that limit. Techbots have already reached 1.2 crores of loan, while Robotronics are dangerously close to that. Robotronics can take about another 1,460 rupees. That's it. And then banks will no longer lend them any more money. And you also see that other companies like RoboS are very close. RoboKing and AI got another 20 lakhs before banks stopped giving them any more loan. And Robotronics, you see, have exhausted their loans. But why did they exhaust their loan? Because they took a lot of money and bought two plants, which may not have been the best decision because they've exhausted all their cash, which they could have used or which they would need in the future of their company. And finally, when you looked at the retained earnings, you see that all the companies have negative retained earnings. And we also know that what does a shareholder get? A shareholder gets to take home his capital or common stock plus retained earnings. In this case, if a shareholder Singhania were to close Robotronics today, Singhania would get to take home 30 lakhs minus 48 lakhs, which means Singhania has to pay 18 lakhs from his pocket to close the company. And if you look at Techbot, Singhania has to pay 30 lakhs minus 12 minus 92 lakhs. So Singhania has to pay 92 lakhs even to shut this company down, which is not a great place to be in. But then again, Singhania is not looking at closing this company in the short term. He is looking at the long term for the company and looking at how the company is going to perform in the long term.